guys, welcome back to Relax My Cat. My name is Savannah, and with me modelling today, not with me today while I'm filming this because she's not feeling very well, is Mia. And today's video is a kind of ridiculous one, but it has a good message. So with that said, this week's video is clothing for cats, or Maya's wardrobe tour. Okay, so I'll be going through a few items of clothing that Mia has acquired over the years, the reasons why we bought them, how they could maybe be helpful for your cat too. That's really what I want to talk about, how I know it's silly to dress your cat in clothing, but sometimes cat clothes can have a really, really good effect or use. So the first note is never leave your cat in any kind of clothing. Just, you know, on its own, because they can get caught on things and that can be really dangerous. And so if you're leaving your cat, make sure all the clothes are removed. Okay, so her first piece is her lab coat, as you've seen many times in these videos. This honestly was mainly a prop for videos, but this little baby shirt, it's around about 0 to 3 months, which is a perfect fit for a small cat. And most cats actually, is actually really good to have around if your cat hates cones or has had surgery recently. Unfortunately, I don't have any pictures, but when Mia was younger and she was first spayed, there was a complication and she had this huge internal bleeding that she had to go back in for an operation with. And basically this little shirt meant that she didn't have to wear a collar and it kept her stitches nice and safe, so she couldn't get at them. But at the same time, the collar wasn't catching on the carpet and she had to be quarantined and everything. It was awful. And that little shirt just meant she had a tiny little bit of comfort that wasn't as awkward as trying to maneuver with this huge plastic thing around your head. I can't even imagine how that would be. Next, Mia has a little jumper. I have that one here. This little jumper is one that I made out of an old hat, because basically when we take her for walks and it's really, really, really cold, she's an indoor cat. She's not really used to the cold as much, and she's also very old. And I just want to make sure that she's nice and warm and safe. Sometimes her fur can thin a little bit where her scar is. So I just want to make sure that she's nice and warm, and that's why she has this for when we go on really cold walks, to keep her nice and toasty. On the note of this one as well, anyone who owns a Sphinx cat or any cats with quite thin fur, maybe like Cornish Rexes, they'll know that they will need some kind of clothing. It is a must if your cat doesn't have any hair, because how are they supposed to keep warm? And I guess for this one, I wanted to say that clothing for me is more of a practical thing than just something for fun. But having said that, we have Mia's Halloween costume that she wore last year. And on a similar note, we have her Christmas pudding suit as well. This is actually one that was for dogs, but it fits her really well. And she actually enjoys this one the most out of all of the ones that we have, so dog clothing. Those kinds of things though, we kind of put on for a novelty, and then once everyone's seen how cute she looks, it comes off, because she's in the house with those, she doesn't really need them. They're not important. Those are just for fun, and if your cat doesn't like being dressed up, don't dress her up. Oh gosh, Mia is, we're so lucky that Mia is just the most relaxed cat in the world. She really doesn't mind, and she actually likes some of her clothes. So we have a little scarf as well. It's just made out of an old shirt, just mainly because when she had a lot of blood tests taken, they shaved off the fur on her neck. So when we were going out in the cold, I was scared that it was going to get cold, so a little scarf just did the job better. The jumper we have didn't really cover that area, and also the scarf meant that her harness wasn't rubbing against the skin. So there you go, another practical use for cat clothing. There are some. I really wanted to knit her one, but I didn't have the right wool, so she has this little rag instead. So there you go, cat clothes can be useful. I know Mia prefers them, other than the freezing cold, that is the alternative. And as always, I'd never put Mia in anything that makes her feel uncomfortable. And you should only really dress your cat if you have a good reason to, say the cold or surgery, and definitely, you know, if they don't mind it too. So that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. I had fun. I hope you found something useful out of it. If you liked it, go ahead and like, leave a comment and let me know. I absolutely adore reading all your comments, so please don't be shy, leave us a comment. And I noticed a lot of you did like linking your cat's Instagrams. Do that if you wish, I like that too. And don't forget to subscribe to us as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Thank you, bye bye.